So Prolia is a new drug, and it's innovative in that it's one of the, it is the first directed human immune globulin monoclonal antibody. So it's actually working on the immune system. And what it does is it interferes with this protein called the rank ligand protein, which actually affects osteoclasts, and it actually prevents their formation, their maturation, and their survival rates. And so what happens is that really is that Prolia is working by in affecting the whole remodeling of bone. It's actually similar in mechanism of action to the bisphosphonates that everyone's most familiar with, but this is working on the immune system in that sort of mechanism, whereas bisphosphonates are more of a chemical interaction. So it's very, very different, but similar in mechanism of action to bisphosphonates, in that it's, but it's working on the immune system. Again, when you there's been several large studies showing significant benefits both to fracture rates and improvements in bone density. It's been compared to, in one study, to the bisphosphonates, alendronate, and again, it's shown superior results in fracture and bone density to the bisphosphonates. Of course, of concern is the more serious potential, where there's potential lowering of blood calcium, higher rates of infections, even higher rates of skin problems, and also, in several of these studies, higher rates of cancer, but not being significant at this point. This is, of course, the concern, is that it's working in a new way. It's interfering with the immune system, which Icarus has a role. These particularly, there's very important cells called T lymphocytes, which are very important in the immune system. So is it increasing rates of infections or cancers or some other conditions that we weren't aware of? And that we have only a 3-year study. So the longest it's been studied is 3 years. And there's some extensions of the existing study, which are going as long as 5 years. But absolutely, that's the big concern, is it? You know, what is happening in the long term with this drug? I think this is what happened with the bisphosphonates, is that you had this migration to preventative, to people who had very low risk of an actual fracture being prescribed drugs preventatively. So do we really want to be cautious with Prolia, which is a new mechanism of action, which affects the immune system, which has potentially some serious long-term effects, which we aren't aware of over time, that it is absolutely used in people who are at the most risk of actually having a fracture? You know, people that have, say, high risk of an actual osteoporotic fracture. And that it is not used until more data is available in people who are at low to moderate risk or no risk or being used preventatively. And then when I use a word of concern, I think that's very, very, I was very strong, but I think it's really important that people use it appropriately, and they're using other very well established and safe, you know, treatments for mild to moderate or prevention, which is exercise and nutrition. In the drug only, options, I think it's more effective in the current studies than bisphosphonates. It's certainly not as powerful as Forteo, but it has some advantages in that it doesn't interact with some other drugs. It doesn't have some of the esophageal effects. It's very convenient in dosing. It seems to have very little effects on clear, in terms of problems with respect to kidney clearance and liver function. So it has kind of a unique profile. The big concern, of course, is what is it doing in the long term, and is it being reserved for currently at risk patients? So you don't want to cause all these problems long term that are more dangerous than the actual drug, the risk of a fracture. So that's the main concern for it. Okay. when people are arriving here, you know, we're looking at all their drugs, ensuring that there's not other agents that are interfering with their bone density. We want to make sure that they're using a superior exercise program, that we do assessments and measure their actual vitamin D levels so that it's not left to chance, because there's a variations in absorption of vitamin D. So we ensure that all our clients are above the 100 nanomolar per liter of 25 hydroxy vitamin D. We establish adequate calcium intake at a minimum of 500 milligrams per day. We assess other nutrients and other functions in the body that have been proven to increase bone density. So we're trying to create a very holistic approach in our recommendations.